What's up, guys? Anton here from Dropship Lifestyle. And in today's episode of Dropship Weekly, we are going to be talking about the best Shopify landing page builders to use in 2019. So let's get into it. I think a good starting point is to talk about what a landing page actually is. Okay, what is a landing page? Now, really, it's just a page on your website that people land on. So sounds pretty obvious, right? And by land, I mean they go to. But when we're talking about landing pages with e-commerce or really any type of internet marketing and online marketing, what we're referring to is a page where we're sending paid traffic. So let's say you're buying ads on Google, on Bing, on Facebook, on Instagram, on Pinterest. Now, the page or set of pages that you send people to, those would be referred to as landing pages because that is where your traffic is landing. And now that we know that, let's talk about what makes a good landing page or what makes a landing page good. Now, there's a few things, but really what you need to do is know the objective of the page before you even set out to have it created or even think about creating it. And this is because different landing pages serve different purposes. For example, you might have a landing page that is built to collect leads. So something where you're asking for a name and an email address, maybe a phone number, maybe even a physical address. But again, that would be a lead gen landing page. You're generating leads. Now, another type of landing page would be for sales. So you're sending people there with the goal of having them add an item to their cart and buy it from you right there on the spot. Another type of landing page could be where you're collecting applications, or maybe where you're having businesses inquire about your services or about wholesale inquiries. So again, all different types of landing pages. And when you're building them, the key thing here is to keep them simple and don't build everything into one page. The reason we build these landing pages is so, again, we can send targeted traffic to exactly where it should be going. And so we can build a unique experience that gets right to the point and that is simple so that when we're spending money on ads and the paid traffic is coming in, we have the best chance of having our landing page convert that visitor into a lead, into a buyer, into an applicant, or whatever it may be. Okay, now that we know that, let's talk about how we actually build these things, how we create these landing pages. Now, first of all, if you're not selling on Shopify and if you never plan to sell on Shopify, I would just go ahead and recommend that you use a tool called ClickFunnels. ClickFunnels is a great piece of software, but I do not recommend it for the type of e-commerce stores that we build. If you want to see why, I did a video not too long ago. It's called ClickFunnels versus Shopify. I will post a link up in the cards that you can click, and I'll post a link in the description of this video, and we can get into depth there. But again, assuming you want to build out a complete e-commerce store, and assuming you either already use the Shopify platform or you want to use the Shopify platform, then you have a couple options when it comes to building landing pages. Now, the first, which I do recommend for most people, is just using the theme that you already have. Now, one of the great things about Shopify is they have a theme store. And similar to WordPress, if you've ever used WordPress, you can go online, you can look for Shopify themes, you can go to the Shopify theme store, and you could pretty much find a design, call it a design, a template, a layout, whatever. You could pretty much find one that would suit any type of store you want to build. And once you have that, you can build pages within that store. Now, if you want to get super technical and if you want a timer over here and a box with a, you know, yellow background here and five images across the middle and a video down there and all these like specialized components, well, then if you want to do that with your Shopify theme, that's where things start getting tricky. You could do it all, but it would require a knowledge of coding because you'll have to go into the back end of Shopify. You'll have to edit some code. And again, definitely doable, but it's something that is not for anybody that's brand new to this and that's never played around with code before. Okay. So again, it's possible, but the more complex that you want to build your landing pages within a normal Shopify theme, the more technical skill it will require. With that being said, if you want to use your default Shopify theme or the Shopify theme you purchase and build something like a landing page to collect leads, right? One of those lead gen pages, not complicated. Pretty much anybody could figure that out. You don't need an additional piece of software. Okay, so keep that in mind. Again, as complexity goes up, that's where technical know-how goes up as well. So you do have some other options. options, okay? Again, if you don't want to use your theme, if you don't want to figure out the technical part yourself, if you don't want to outsource the technical part, you can use what is known as a drag and drop builder to create Shopify landing pages. Now, what's important to note when you're comparing Shopify themes with Shopify drag and drop landing page builders is it's not one or the other. If you have a Shopify theme and you start using a drag and drop page builder, it gets installed as an app. So if you're familiar with Shopify, you have themes and then you have apps. It's not one or the other. Again, you keep your theme, your site can look the same, but then you install your drag and drop app, and with that, you can make new pages. So it's not going to change the way your entire store looks. It's not going to overwrite everything you've already done. It's going to allow you to create these unique pages that you want to be highly customized and highly, you know, unique, I would say. Now, here's what's important to note about that. If you go ahead and use one of these landing page builders, you need to have an eye for design, or have the person using it have an eye for design, because again, it's not linked to your theme. So your typography, your color scheme, all the, you know, design work that's been put into your store, it doesn't transfer over by default. And what that means is if you're someone like me that can't design anything, it's very possible to go ahead and start using one of these tools and build a very unattractive landing page that doesn't match the rest of your site at all. So keep that in mind. Again, you need to either have some design knowledge or have the person using it have some design knowledge. Now, when it comes to the tools that are available now, there's pretty much three of them that people use. I'm only going to talk about two of them because they're the ones that most people use, the ones that we've used ourselves, and the ones that have the best reviews. Now, the first is called Zipify Pages. That is from Ezra Firestone from smartmarketer.com. Ezra, great guy, but that probably was released maybe, I don't even know, a year and a half, 2 years ago, and it is a tool that's paid. I definitely believe if you're going to buy one of these tools, if you're going to use one of these tools, I should say, you should go with a paid one, because free software never works. It's not supported. Software costs money for development. So his tool, Zipify Pages, is $67 per month. Good news, they have a 14-day free trial. I'm not an affiliate or anything, but if you want to check it out, you could check it out, play with it for 14 days, see if it makes sense for you. Now, the good thing about Ezra's tool is he includes the templates that he uses on his Shopify stores. You know, he has a couple of different stores. They do over 8 figures in sales, so definitely knows what he's doing, definitely has designs that work. Doesn't mean they're going to work for your store, but it's a good starting point. So at least it has that going for it, right? And again, 14-day free trial, so see if it makes sense for you or not. Now, the other one that has a lot more reviews and based on what I see in Shopify is a lot more popular is called Shogun. Now, Shogun, again, we've used it. It is a tool very similar to Zipify. The thing with Shogun is, I don't want to say this, but their templates I don't like as much as Zipify's. And when we've went in there and when I've tried to use it, again, as someone with, you know, no technical or design experience, I've made some pretty ugly pages myself. That's why I recommend, though, if you're like me and you have no design ability, you shouldn't even be using these tools yourself anyway, because it's really not gonna make that big of a difference. In fact, if you're thinking too, oh, and by the way, Shogun, I wrote down the most recent price. $39 a month is the plan you would want to be in, the one that's comparable to Zipify. So Shogun, you're at $39 a month. Zipify, you're at $67 a month. Both of them have the free trials, so you could try them out, see which one you like better. Again, the reason I do like Zipify a little bit better is because Ezra gives you his templates, and I know he has like a ton of his team on that product supporting it, not just with, you know, customer support, but with development. But Shogun, I'm sure is a great product as well. Now, again, don't use these if you're just starting. If you think $39 a month extra or $67 a month extra is ridiculous, then don't worry, you're not ready for it yet, because by the time you would even need a tool like this, your business is gonna be, you know, the point where that's just nothing. It's well worth it to have a page that's gonna generate you a lot more money. So again, if you're thinking those prices are ridiculous, you're just not there yet, which is fine. And even if you are there yet, where the prices don't seem bad, you still might not need one of these. Again, within your theme, you can do a lot. You really can create both of what either of those tools will do for you. It's just gonna take some more technical know-how, maybe maybe you're going to outsource the work to someone on Upwork and they're going to do it for you. But again, you know, don't just go ahead out and go out there and think, okay, I'm not technical. I just signed up for Shopify. I need a landing page builder. I'm going to do this myself and make all these great pages and collections. Because if you have no design skills anyway, if your site is brand new, then these tools will probably hurt you more than they will help you. So keep that in mind. In no way are they necessary. The Shopify theme store has themes that are amazing, that are gorgeous, that are fast, that look good across all pages, and that will keep that consistent flow across your website. So listen, if you're gonna sign up for one of these tools, one of these drag and drop page builders, it should be because you're already generating a ton of sales and profit. It should be because you have clear objectives of what you want these landing pages to do. It should be because you don't wanna build them yourself or outsource it within your theme. And it should be because you're not afraid to actually get in there, do the work, or hire someone to build these pages out for you. So hope you found that useful. I'll post links, not affiliate links, just normal links, so you can go check them out, do the free trials, see if you like them, and let me know your thoughts in the comments. Love to hear it. With that being said, guys, I will see you next week for our next episode of Dropship Weekly. Thank you.